How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about WireGuard, and some of you guys have been asking, hey, is WireGuard a safe protocol in your VPN? Most VPNs are implementing WireGuard as a new age protocol, and it has been going on for a few years. Typically, you might see, for example, here in NordVPN, OpenVPN was the typical protocol that most people would use. It's quick, it's secure, and it has been the industry standard for many, many years. But recently, WireGuard has been kicked off, and today I just wanted to take a look at WireGuard and tell you guys if it's safe or not. Now, NordLynx is a WireGuard protocol. It's just called NordLynx and NordVPN. We do have a WireGuard protocol in Surfshark and a WireGuard-like protocol with Express VPN called Lightweight UDP. By the way, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about them. But here we're talking about the WireGuard protocol, so let's get straight to it. Now, I just pulled out a couple of, let's say, just audits examining the WireGuard, and these are public audits that you can take a look at. So this is a security analysis of WireGuard from spring 2018. I just wanted to quickly jump to the conclusion. All right, so overall, we found that WireGuard generally functions as it should. The protocol indeed was very simple, and we found out how easy it was to set up. The design philosophy indeed led to a concise and simple design. We did not identify any critical bugs, but we did find some areas of WireGuard that could be improved. All right. Moving on to another security kind of audit that I found, and let me just go down straight to the conclusion. And there we go. All right, so in less than 4,000 lines of code, WireGuard demonstrates that it is possible to have secure network tunnels that are simply implemented, extremely performant, make use of state-of-the-art cryptography, and remain easy to administer. The simplicity allows it to be very easily independently verified and re-implemented on a wide diversity of platforms. The cryptographic constructions and primitives utilized ensure high speed in a wide diversity of devices, from data center servers to cell phones, as well as dependable security properties well into the future. The ease of deployment will also eliminate many of the common and disastrous pitfalls currently seen with many IPsec deployments. Described around the time of its introduction by Ferguson the Schneier, I'm not really sure how to say that, IPsec was a great disappointment to us, given the quality of the people that worked on it and the time that was spent on it. We expected a much better result. Our main criticism of IPsec is its complexity. WireGuard, in contrast, focuses on simplicity and usability, while still delivering a scalable and highly secure system. By remaining silent to unauthenticated packets, and by not making any allocations and generally keeping resource utilization to a minimum, it can be deployed on the outer edges of networks as a trustworthy and reliable access point, which does not readily reveal itself to attackers nor provide a viable attack target. The crypto key routing table paradigm is easy to learn and will promote safe network designs. The protocol is based on cryptographically sound and conservative principles, using well-understood yet modern crypto primitives. WireGuard was designed from a practical perspective meant to solve real-world secure networking problems. And yes, 4,000 lines of code as opposed to OpenVPN's around 70,000 lines of code. So this definitely is meant for simplicity and practicality. So is WireGuard safe? Yes, it is safe. And, you know, there's a reason why a lot of VPNs are implementing WireGuard. So if you guys are interested in VPNs that implement WireGuard itself, you can use NordVPN and Surfshark. And ExpressVPN will offer something that is akin to WireGuard called Lightweight UDP. It's also been made based on the simplicity of WireGuard, but it's not actually WireGuard, but it is something that's very similar and it performs very well. It's just a proprietary WireGuard based protocol for ExpressVPN, whereas NordVPN and Surfshark, they utilize the actual WireGuard, let's say, infrastructure. All right, so that's pretty much it for this video. If you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews. Hopefully I answered you guys' question. And if you guys have any more questions, feel free to post them in the comments down below. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. It'll help me out a lot. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.